Hello and welcome you to Burnout 3 Takedown. This game is from 2004. Yes, it is 12 years old. This is one of the games I played most of my childhood, and I just recently found out how to run it on an emulator, so I'm going to be playing a series where I complete the game as best I can, to 100%. Yes, welcome to Burnout. I'm going to adjust the volumes here really quick because this is really loud. There we go. Alright, welcome. So as I said, I'm running this on an emulator. You'll notice that, as you see, the buttons will be for a PlayStation 2. I originally played this on the original Xbox back when, I think, the year after it came out. So it's been a very long time since I last played this game. But I really love, just, it brings back a lot of nostalgia being able to play this game. Also, I do apologize about the audio. This is the best that I could do with the current setup, which is I'm using Open Broadcast Software audio capture to record along with the video. The only other option that I could see doing would be to record separately the audio and then have to cut both the audio and the video and put them together post, and that is an extremely large amount of work to take to get the audio to line up very well with the video. So for right now, until I can find a more reliable way of recording audio and video at the same time, I'm just going to stick with this. It's not the greatest, it could be better, but for right now, it's what I can do without spending a ridiculous amount of time. So without further ado, I have played a little bit just to make sure that the game actually worked. There will be a few bugs, I can almost guarantee. Another reason that I don't want to record separately is because I have the feeling there might be a few crashes. And yeah, I don't really feel like chopping up that much audio. Alright, so, lots of different options here. I'm just going to go for the career for right now. So I've completed 3 events, that's it. Basically going to be watching me play this entire game from start.
What are you doing?
Excuse me.
Yeah, you're listening to Crash FM. That's a good thing. Looks like something is going off near Silver Lake. If it's not another monster carp catching competition down at the quayside, then it's got to be some of our finest burners getting ready to prove their worth. For all your racing info, keep on listening to Crash FM.
I really wish those were skippable, but, you know, I can't complain too much. I'm really sorry if you can hear that in the background. It's my roommate's girlfriend. I apologize. Anyway, alright, let's go do this. Also, sorry if I have long periods of silence. I'm not really used to commenting while driving. So the controls for this are a little bit odd because it is an emulator. This is one of the only ways I can get this game to work in my current situation. And try to take down. Alright, so this game is all about getting takedowns and getting boost from those takedowns. Obviously, the more opponents you hit, the more takedowns you get, the more boost you get. You can also get boosts from other things, like going close to cars but not actually hitting them. Like, that's a bad example. But, so you might notice right now that the sky is black and not actually a sky. This is because I forgot to do a very important step before selecting a car, which is changing the render type in the emulator. I'm not sure if I'm going to have to do it every single time, but for right now, just see if it works the next time. I'm not sure if it'll mess up the recording when I do it as well. I probably should have tested that before doing the recording, but you know, I don't believe in too much pre-made things. Too much setup is unrealistic, in my opinion. Oh yeah, so when you crash, you get an aftertouch mode where you can control your car after you've crashed. It's possible to get aftertouch takedowns, and you can get as many as possible while you're still moving. And the more you move, the more takedowns you're obviously able to get. Also, I did turn off the takedown camera. For some reason, it still does that, where wow, I went way off course there. It will take away from the car view. There are some instances, though, where the takedown camera can keep you from dying. Whereas you hit something and it would kill you instantly. If you're in takedown mode, I missed the takedown there. If you're in takedown mode, you can not die from things that would otherwise kill you, like hitting a car head on, which is convenient sometimes, but most of the time not. I apologize for, you know, like I said, it's an emulator, so there's going to be a little bit of glitchiness to it. Fortunately, yesterday I was playing and the audio had a very weird sound to the cars, and that appears to not be happening today, so that's lucky for me.
Route out of here? Actually, so do I, but in the meantime, catch the takedown action. Our burners are just lining up and it's gonna be sick. You're listening to Crash FM.
But yes, there's other things you can do besides just hitting people to get some boost, like drifts in air and oncomings, which is where you just sit in the opposite lane of traffic as long as possible. There's some maps in this game where you can get like 4 mile oncoming, where you're basically just in the opposite wrong way lane the entire time. It looks like I'm gonna get first in this race. Yep, here we go. Oh, this is an event. Right, okay, so this is gonna be multiple races, and the person with the most points at the end of the race will be the winner. See, I'm remembering how this game works as I'm playing it. It's probably been 8 years since I've last played this game.
Crash
Man, it was so fun
again.
Though.
Tons of tourist RVs out today by the lake. Take care with these so-called out-of-towners. With all your racing info, stay Crash FM.
Signature takedown. Those are when specific ways of killing your enemies are required. In this instance, it's hitting these large yellow poles. You have to crash them into them. Another aspect of this game that I really like is the fact that there is actually really decent civilian AI, I guess would be the best term for it. Just the casual traffic going on. So in the bottom left there, you can see my oncoming is increasing. I've got a single star, now it's a 2-star. Going for a 3-star here. Out of boost, but getting a little bit back. There we go, 3-star oncoming. So the longer I sit here, the more boost I'll gather from just driving in the wrong lane there. It's a second's way behind me right now. That's good. I like to keep a little bit of distance, but they can catch up to you eventually. Ooh, that was really close there. I really like the soundtrack in this game as well. A lot of really good songs, really good bands.
What's up, I am Stryker, up on the roof of the work buildings, trying to get a view down onto the waterfront run. If you were thinking of doing the same thing, don't bother, you can't see squat up here. Whose dumbass idea was this anyway? Probably my ex-girlfriend's. Crash FM, telling you where to be and where not to be.
A lot of quips that I'm only now understanding. I didn't get when I originally played this game, when I was, what, 10 or so? I see somebody coming up here. Might be able to get an aftertouch if I can, you know, see where I'm going. Oh, no. Nope. There he is. I need more boost. Ooh, that was a close one. I could have died hitting that edge there.
Welcome to Crash FM with me, Stryker. If you're steaming off the I-5, Silver Lake.
This right behind
is the home of pescado. This is the home of fish. Silverfish, apparently. And one big lake. Also, the hottest burnout action inside of the state.
So, if they do hit you hard enough, as you might be able to see here, you can get killed by them. Obviously, anyone can kill anyone. But more than likely, they won't get you in a single blow. They'll have to get you pretty hard. Beautiful. And I think that was the last race in this series. Was not. I just assumed that since it said, win this race to get gold, that meant that it was the last race. But clearly that is not the case. Let's keep going here.
Race GP rules aren't too complex.
Also, I will put all the details about how I'm running this in the description of the video. So that anyone curious to do this themselves can see there how to do this. Ooh, almost got taken out there. Oh, I didn't get that one takedown. Wow, it's been a long time since I've played. I used to be really good at drifting around that corner. I get too far ahead of them, and then I don't get any boost. Sometimes I need to slow down. Once again, I apologize for any kind of glitches you might see. This is an emulator, so it's not going to be perfect. There he is. Gotcha. Oh, so close to not dying. Here we go. Let's do this. Still in first? How? I honestly don't know how I'm still in first, that's kind of surprising. I'm down to, you can see my boost, little boost thing, my amount of boost I can total hold is now reduced because I have died on multiple occasions. Oh boy, I'm really starting to lag down here, that's a little bit concerning. I might have to change some graphical settings for this. I can hear the audio glitches starting to come in as well. For right now it's working though. I'll try and do it the best I can with what we got here. Man, I really love this game. It doesn't even look terrible for being 12 years old.
Have you been running today?
I mean, besides the sky not working, but
well,
like I said, that's the emulator, not the,
the action
not the
is fast
game.
And frenzied, the weather is great, and the tracks are perfect. And not just the ones I've been laying on. I am Stryker, giving you all the news here on Crash FM.
Wow, a lot of quips I never understood in this game. It's pretty funny. The music, though, in this game is just absolutely phenomenal. They really did good with the selection. Still? Usually it'll shoot a message on the top of the screen there that says how far you are from the rival, how far away the rivals are. Either how far behind they are, or how far ahead you are. I'm not seeing it at the moment, which is odd. I was going to say something else, but I forgot completely what it was. What was I going to say? Oh yes, some vehicles in the game will, like, they will dodge for you. If you're driving on the wrong side of the road, they will actively try to hit you, which is a little bit annoying, but most of them will just stay in their lane. It seems to be taxis most of the time. I think that's pretty funny. Still no rifles behind you, it's kind of concerning. Especially since I'm so close to the finish line. Oh, I missed that. I saw it and I didn't read it, because I'm a dummy. There we go. Alright. So, you can see I've got a bunch of points right there from the end of the game. So getting certain amounts of points and getting certain amounts of takedowns unlocks more vehicles in the game. Right now I've only unlocked one car because I have not played basically at all. I'm basically starting this as a series from the beginning. So now I've unlocked the second class of car. Excuse me. Oh, I guess I couldn't skip that. I was a little bit concerned that I broke the game. Alright, so it looks like I got the muscle type 1. Type 1, yep, that's how they label it. Okay, I'm remembering. And is this a tuned? Yes, it is. So I unlocked another tuned vehicle, which is the first class there. Oh, no, muscle type 2. Oh, that's right, I unlocked 5 cars. Another muscle car? Yep. Muscle type 3. Okay, so at the top there you can see this one is 1 because I won 4 gold medals. Oh, it says at the bottom as well, I guess. Okay, so this is the compact series. It's not tuned, my bad. So like I said, you get points for doing certain things. There we go. I have won another car because I reached another point. Let's see what this one is. Muscle, looks like. I'm not sure how it chooses which one is the next one to go. I would have thought that would have been the compact series would have been my next. The compact series would have been the next one to unlock something. Alright. So, let me see if I can go here and see if I can look at my garage. Oh, this is cool. So yeah, I'm gonna try and get this game to 100% completion as best I can without breaking the game. I think I might have to lower the settings because it's not doing the audio glitching a ton in the race, which is very odd. So let me just see. Okay, I can see the garage from here. So alright, so we have the compact series here. This car is not available, but it says there, awarded for gold and waterfront face-off, so that's how I unlock that car. So at the bottom of each series is the Dominator car. It is the fastest vehicle of that series, and they always have flame paint jobs. So there might be a race in the future where you can see the Dominator car. Like I said, these ones you can change the colors of. For example, this one I was driving can be white, blue, or red, and I just had white because it's different. But the Dominator series is the fastest, it's always a flame paint job, you can't change it, and it's the fastest. So keep going here. Coupe Series, Sport Series, Super Series, Special, Heavyweights. So this is stuff that you really only use in crash mode. Crash truck, fire truck. So yeah, so that's the garage there. So I'm gonna do one more race, and then I'm gonna end the episode for today. Mostly because I'm really not sure how this is all going to turn out. This is the first time I'm recording a video with OBS, so this will be very interesting to see what kind of quality I get out of it. So, actually, you know what? I'll do a race in Europe since I got one, I think, unlocked. Yes, I have one.
Crash FM back again. All right, everyone. I've been picking up some serious airtime testing out your route along the tree-lined avenue. Hit that right, and you're flying! Stick around for all the circuit happenings here on Crash FM.
It's obviously a Ford GT. No licensed cars, of course, because that would require actual money. Oh, I forgot to point out in the bottom there that it did show the speed and weight of the vehicle, and the stats do change between cars of the same class. So,
Crash
you
FM
actually
back
do get
again,
advantages.
And you just gotta
I
love
forgot to
crazy
do it again.
Europeans. All right,
you know,
so
I'm gonna
got
stop
a little
the video,
more history than
and
I'm used to.
I'm gonna try and
it's great to see it being
get
used
it
as
to
such a cool
see if I can fix
those
it.
Ancient
so, it's instructed online that if I press F9 to change render, this should fix the issue of the sky being black. So, let's see if that works. I'm really hoping it does. That would be very nice. And then I will be able to say,
you know,
see if
Europeans just have way too much style.
It has to be done every single race.
Oh,
that did not
crazy.
Fix it. Okay.
Mixing it up with them on the vineyard circuit is
but
surely
not
the
work,
best way to
unfortunately.
Help maintain close international relations. Stay with Crash for all your
not
circuit
problem.
News.
I apologize for not talking much right here. It's going to be requiring a lot of my focus. Get this done as fast as possible. Oh no, 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 no. The goal in this event is to just get the fastest time possible. I don't remember what the time is. It's up there in the top left. We have 20 seconds. So I've got 20 seconds left to get to the finish line right there. Huh. I guess I got it. Alright guys, so this is Burnout 3 Takedown. I will be doing more videos in this series as time progresses. Hopefully I can get some of these issues fixed in the future. But yeah, I'm really excited that I got this to work. Very happy that I was able to do this. I really do love this game. And it just brings back so many memories. This was one of the few games I played actually on the original Xbox. It was maybe 3 or 4. And I played this so much. I got nearly 100% back on the old Xbox there. And I'll be trying to do 100% here. Alright, I will see you guys in the next video.